Welcome to another video about the fossil record. My name is Benjamin Berger. One of the great aspects of making these videos is that I get to explore some of the more obscure fossil groups that don't often get included in textbooks or large survey courses that examine the entire fossil record of vertebrates. There's just not enough time to discuss these little known groups of fossils. But in this video, I want to discuss a very obscure order of mammals that are only known to have existed during a very short duration, exclusively in North America, immediately following the extinction of the dinosaurs. They're not widespread, and because they're rare in the fossil record and geographically localized here in the United States, they never appear in movies, documentaries, or popular media, such as video games. And even Wikipedia lacks entries for most members of this fossil group. The earliest Paleocene epoch, when they lived, was a time of radical experimentation for the surviving small mammals 65 million years ago. We kind of tend to remember only the groups of mammals that succeeded during this period of experimentation and that are found later in the fossil record, such as their own order, the primates. But others like artiodactyls, perissodactyls, carnivores, elephants, sloths, rodents, etc. However, I think it is good to look at some of the groups that did not. The Taeniodonta were first discovered in 1874, independently by both Edward Drinker Cope and his rival, O.C. Marsh. Cope described a fossil mammal he called Ectogeneus, based on some fragmentary teeth and jaws from the Paleocene of New Mexico, while Marsh described a similar fossil he called Styleniodon from the Middle Eocene of Wyoming. Both creatures exhibited bizarre teeth. These teeth were built for crushing. Most mammals during this time, and even today, have a complex set of cusps that interlock between the upper and lower teeth. This allows both slicing and chewing, a very efficient way to process food. The Taeniodonts obliterated this finely tuned interlocking cusps on their teeth and evolved blunt battering rams like teeth that resembled a pestle and mortar approach to processing food. Like a pestle and mortar, the thickly enameled teeth would smash into each other, grinding hard food into smaller pieces. These teeth were uniquely adapted to crushing roots and wood. Mammals had never before exploited roots and wood as a food source. Moles and other subterranean mammals tend to go after worms and other soft subterranean invertebrates, or eat softer vegetation on the surface. While modern rodents such as voles will eat roots, they tend to eat solely the tender shoots of vegetation. Tough roots and wood are simply off limits of what can be processed. Taeniodonts were more akin to modern North American porcupines and beavers, which eat bark off trees and can process food by using ever-growing incisors and blunt molar-like teeth. Taeniodonts were the first mammalian group to eat this hard wood and roots, and develop the ability to continually to grow their incisors and replace the wearing surface on their teeth like modern rodents, as well as continually growing their massive, robust molar teeth for crushing tough and hard wood, bark, and roots. This meant that they did not have to worry about their teeth wearing away. Taeniodonts are divided into two families. The first, the Conrichtiidae, are typified by the early Paleocene genus Onychodectes. These fossils were small, generalized mammals that demonstrate adaptations in the teeth for an omnivore diet, with blunt teeth, but also retaining some sharp teeth, such as pointy canine teeth. Their skulls are long and they were clawed, and they likely dug and scavenged during the early Paleocene. But by about 60 million years ago, they went extinct. The other family is called the Staeniodontidae, and while not as diverse as the other group, containing only four genera, their fossil record extends until about 40 million years ago. They stuck around, in part because of the ability to process food that other mammals were unable to eat. The Staeniodontidae had short, football helmet-like skulls with pug-like noses, allowing them to scrape wood and bark from trees, with massive attachment sites for chewing muscles. The limbs were heavily clawed, while strong flexing muscles useful for both digging and climbing. They've been referred to as an aardvark with the head of a pig, but may have been more closely resembling sloths that live in trees with their strong limbs and long claws from which they could hang from branches. A wonderfully nearly complete skeleton of the Eocene Staeniodon was described in 2004 by the late paleontologist Bill Turnbull at the Field Museum in Chicago. The skeleton features a massive and thick skull and jaw, as well as rows of peg-like teeth. The short limbs show adaptations for strong muscles that would be useful for scrambling around trees and tearing bark and wood off to chew on. This specimen of Staeniodon was one of the last of its kind. After the Middle Eocene, they disappear from the fossil record, perhaps due to the cooling temperatures and retreat of the dense forests where Staeniodon found a home within. Taeniodonts are often confused with another, more geographically widespread group of mammals called the Taeniodonts, which are more common in the early Eocene, likely arriving from Asia into North America around the time of the Paleocene-Eocene boundary. They also show adaptations toward ever-growing incisors and more blunt-like molar teeth, but not to the extent as seen in the Taeniodonts. They still maintained some slight cusps and crests on their molar teeth. They likely competed with the native Taeniodonts, but both groups lived in the same place and the same time for several million years, with the Taeniodonts becoming more arboreally adapted, taking perhaps to living higher in the trees, while the Taeniodonts may have become more terrestrial, roaming around on the ground. Taeniodonts are very rare. In graduate school, my advisor, Dr. Jalen Eberle, found a beautiful specimen of Ectoganeus in an outcrop covered in black basalt. The bone, being black as well, was really difficult to discern from the surrounding black basalt. And it amazed me that the specimen was actually found at all. It was fascinating to see a fossil of this unique creature. And I continue to do field work in rock layers where these creatures are found. And I hope someday to find a specimen of my own. In any case, I want to highlight this unique group of mammals. And despite their incredible rarity, they are an amazing and interesting group because of their strange adaptations. And despite being extinct, they do give us a unique insight into what the world looked like during those years after the extinction of the dinosaurs. I want to thank Brian Clever, Pablo Luzzatto Figuez, Arcotis 1811, Justin Bovey, Emmett Larson, Marlowe Andreco, and Fred Olney. thank you everyone for your support on Patreon. If you'd like to learn more about supporting these educational free videos on paleontology and geology, check out the link in the description below.